I said, wake up. There we go. Well, look at you. In a very, very, very vulnerable position. Just like I've been in the last couple of days. That's right, days. You've been out for days. Finally awake. I could see those really, really pretty eyes of yours. What's the matter? Your heart is racing. Oh, baby, you're gonna want to keep that down. Unless you want your fingers to get cut off by these hedge clippers. There you go. See, was that so hard? That thing in your mouth is to keep you quiet. Let's just call it an insurance. If you talk, I'll turn the knob. And those sheets of metal are going to spread wider and wider and wider. They're going to keep spreading until they're as open as a sunflower, completely tearing apart your jaw in the process. So how about it? You gonna scream? You gonna say anything? Oh, you know what's coming. Don't look so surprised. It's a shame that not everybody could be here for the, procedure. Let's just call it. Though that girl coming out of your dressing room, she was quite the screamer. Oh, yeah. She did not go down without a fight. Speaking of which, before we get started, I've got a present for you. Just give me a second. Here you go. Well, aren't you gonna open it? Oh, right. Your hands are kind of restrained. Yeah, your hands are kind of bolted to the chair, aren't they? Well, then, shall I do the honors? Ta-da! What do you mean, what is it? It's her head. Oh, it's so pretty, isn't she? Natural beauty. Those eyes rolled back. I'm sure it's a look you recognize. Well, go on. Aren't you gonna say hello? Why don't you give her a kiss if you like her so damn much? Well, if her head doesn't do you much good, maybe her hands will. You know, the ones that played the violin oh so beautifully. And I'm sure did one hell of a sonata on your little instrument. Their skin is so soft. So gentle against my cheek. But then again, you've already felt her warmth, haven't you? Funny, isn't it? How life works. You win some, you lose some. 'Tis better to have loved and lost, right? You disgrace me. You go behind my back. Someone else. You told me that I was enough. That I am enough. No one else matters. Specifically not to worry about her. Well, I'm not gonna have to worry about her anymore now, am I? Oh, honey, your heart rate is going really fast. You might want to keep that down, remember? Wouldn't want anything to happen to those pretty little fingers of yours. God. The way it made me feel watching her exit your dressing room. It's like a knife on my skin. Deep. So deep that it feels like the blood wouldn't stop. That nothing could stop it. This knife right here is the same one that got you your little present. I sharpened it for you. Doesn't it feel good? Being dragged up against your skin? According to your heart rate, kind of excites you, doesn't it? But not in that good way that she made you feel, right? No. No, this is a little bit more intimate. Oh, sweetness. I told you not to scream. I know it hurts. I know. I told you to keep quiet. There you go. Oh, honey, are you crying? That's okay. You can cry all you want. It's not gonna change anything now, is it? You made your choice. And now I've made mine. Oh, honey, I don't plan on killing you. Quite the contrary. What good are you to me if you're dead? No, I'm just going to remind you who you belong to. And honey, I'm gonna make sure that you never fucking forget it. That's right. Doesn't it? Watching something that belongs to you walk away so easily. You played absolutely beautifully. I want you to continue to keep playing that sweet melody. Only this time, you'll remember who you belong to. You and I, we belong together. We belong together. We belong together. Nothing is going to change that.